Lancaster Central School District Board of Education meeting to order. In the unlikely event of an emergency, if we do have to evacuate the room, please note the locations of the exits. At this time, I ask you to silence your cell phones and rise for the Pledge of Allegiance. Please remain standing for a moment of Sabbath reflection. Standing for a moment of reflection for Joseph Adamel, a physical education teacher from 1964, who met him a long time ago. Passed away on October 18th. Moving on to presentations, 4.1, we have a tenure presentation. Mr. Crazy. Good evening, everyone. Tonight, I have the opportunity to recognize truly a fabulous educator who's being recognized this evening for their accomplishment of tenure in the high school administration. It is my honor and I take this opportunity to congratulate Mr. Thomas. Mr. Stasiak is a charismatic teacher who's been working with our high school English department for the past 4 years. He shares his passion and enthusiasm of the English language with the students of the Lancaster community. Over the course of the past 4 years, he has shown to be a tremendous asset, not only to the English department, but to the community at large. As I've gotten to know Mr. Stasiak, he demonstrates incredible qualities that make him a phenomenal educator. He's a team player, and he's a leader who puts the students as his primary focus. He has an incredible demeanor, who has always been seen having a smile on his face and greeting everyone with kindness and respect. He is seen participating in school events, chaperoning the homecoming dance, the prom, attending basketball games, softball games, and also working as a football coach. Mr. Stasiak works hard to connect with the students both in and out of the classroom. In the classroom, he challenges the students through various activities and cooperative structures to engage students in the learning process. In addition to these characteristics, he's a very reflective practitioner who's always looking in the mirror to find ways to help himself. Last year, Mr. Stasiak taught PAP English for the first time. He was eager to take on this instructional assignment. When I came to conduct this observation last year, he experimented with a new educational strategy didn't exactly go exactly as planned. However, upon reflection prior to our post-observation conference, he opened up our conversation by recognizing the kind of thought Ryan was, and began to discuss the layout of that instructional strategy and how we would approach using that strategy in the future. In my opinion, being a reflective practitioner is a quality that helps start educating. And I believe Mr. Stasiak has the tools and the abilities of an all-star educator in the Lancaster. Thank you, Mr. Stasiak, for all of the work you do with our students. Congratulations on this great accomplishment. We look forward with you. We look forward to working with you for many years to come. Our motto here in Lancaster is always to hire the best. And Mr. Stasiak, in my opinion, is a great example of that. He's not just a great teacher, he's a great person. Congratulations, Alex.
congratulations again, Alex. Thank you, Mr. Frischman, for that, those touching words. We do say hire the best, and it's an important step for educators to earn tenure. So, again, we congratulate Alex. All right, 5.0, correspondence, 5.1. We have an email, one email on record. 6.0, approval of minutes. 6.1, can I have a motion to approve the regular session from October 7, 2024? Any comments or questions? All those in favor? Anyone against? Motion carries. 7.0, items from staff organizations. Anyone from the Lancaster Administrative and Supervisory Association? Anyone from the Lancaster Central Teachers Association? Anyone from the Lancaster Association of Service Personnel? And anyone from the Lancaster Association of Substitute Teachers? All right. Moving on to 8.0, board reports. I'd just like to take a moment here to recognize that this is Dr. Valley's final weekend. And I want to take some time to really thank him for all the work. We say all the time, hire the best. Well, Dr. Valley, we hired the best in you. And you've created an environment and a culture here in Lancaster that is second to none. We say that this is a destination school district, and Dr. Valley, you're the people. I mean that from the bottom of my heart. Both my kids were fortunate to go through Lancaster, and I wouldn't have wanted to be on this ride with anyone else over the last year. Thank you. Any other board members have anything to report?
Oh, Dr. B. Yes, you know I'm going to report you this. You can say that you can get better. I got to work a few things. We need to change. Think about the leadership starting point. Investing in our future. Think about when you took the grant to the district. They're a pretty big district, but you probably had really investing in the infrastructure there for decades. So you took the grant to do the things that maybe were harder for the past couple of projects to work and have the dollars that necessary to build the resiliency. Let's look at the district. Let's look at the relationships and changes. Let's make sure we're starting something, starting all of it. That's the way that we can sustain this program. We can continue to sustain the future. It's about people stupid. I think we've actually said that. And I appreciate that. And I've watched you be the most humble as I've ever worked with. I don't know anything. And it was all about watching me put help to get the right people to the right spaces and trusting people. And this district is built upon that foundation and reinforced it over time. And a lot of folks come along the way and that works as they need to be built for the partnership. And the last thing I'll say is that we would get wayward. It was like they care about some things. And as individuals, you ask us the one question that continue to set us what's best for the kids? Is it what's best for the kids? And when we go through those times of change, we're navigating really difficult times. For you to ask that question for us, I think it's really important that we're going to be able to make so that things continue to pull us and pressure us in different ways. But if it's best for the kids, and we trust that it's best for the kids, we have to be so, there's a legacy here. I think a lot of folks, we don't know that, we don't know that. The keys to it. And now I'm very confident the administrative staff and the individual employee, I trust that there's a good thing that continues to say something that you have to make a good issue.
All right, I'll keep my comments brief, but I've been on the board now for almost 6 years. Through the time that I've been on the board, I've learned a lot from everybody. I think the most important thing that I've learned is it's really hard to do the right thing. It's hard to do the right thing. It's hard to make those decisions when you know that you're going to push back, negative pushback on the board. And one thing that's consistent throughout the entire time that I've seen control this district is consistently move forward and move to do the next right thing, the next right decision for the kids of this district. And I can't thank you enough for that leadership and that decision in leadership. It's something that I'll remember not forever. It's a leadership lesson that I will take with me for the rest of my life. And just to echo what Glenn said, you definitely left the district in a better place than when you found it. I think the district is set up in an excellent position for future years due to your leadership and your decisions to do the next thing. So I appreciate you and wish you well in your retirement.
All right, I'm going to ask to yourself. I wrote stuff down. Usually I'm not a writer when I speak. I mean, usually more of an off-the-cuff kind of person. But, you know, I wasn't around for the whole time. I'm superintendent. You know, I'm one of the newer board members. I have younger kids in the district. And the big reason I chose Lancaster was, the big reason I chose Lancaster is because a lot of the people I hold dear to me love Lancaster. My mother-in-law, my wife, both attended, and throughout the years of being with them, I've heard stories about how great the district was, you know, an environment that fosters growth, resilience, and respect among peers and students. And that really drew me to studying just the community. It's the values that you've instilled here. It's been, you know, you've been a visionary leader, always putting the well-being of the students, staff, and families at the heart of every decision. You're always thinking one step ahead. I think I said that tons of times to you. So, you know, I just want to thank you for your unwavering commitment and your dedication to each student's journey and leaving a legacy that will inspire my kids' generations to come, you know, being on the younger end of things. And I am obviously sad to see you go, but, you know, I'm excited for what brings you next. You'll help me travel. So, you know, that was something you wanted to do there. So, I wish you the best, and let's love the new chapter.
Thank you. Thank you.
10.0. Does anyone have any old business to discuss? 11.0 new business, 11.1 personnel items, 11.1.1 brand promotion and personnel changes. Any comments or questions? All those in favor? Anyone against? Motion carries. 11.1.2, can I have a motion to appoint acting superintendent of schools? Any comments or questions? All those in favor? Anyone against? Motion carries. 11.1.3, can I have a motion to appoint assistant superintendent for curriculum instruction and pupils? Dr. Kuf, would you have some words on that?
Thank you, Mr. Sage. A year back, I was posted for my current position, Assistant Superintendent of Curriculum Instruction and Pupil Personnel Services. Interviews were conducted last week with 5 highly qualified candidates. All of those candidates had impressive resumes with significant administrative experience at building and district levels. The committee strongly recommends Mr. Andrew Crazen, who is even known to serve as the current Lancaster Director of Secondary Education. For an interview with me, Mr. Craven's on the agenda tonight. As was mentioned, I'm presenting the Board of Education as the next Assistant Superintendent of Curriculum Instruction at PPS for Lancaster Central School District. Mr. Craven has done an outstanding job as Director of Secondary Education. He is passionate about Lancaster, respected by faculty, staff, and colleagues, and cares about people. And maybe most importantly, as we talked about tonight, is a good person. His advanced knowledge of the district and understanding of where we're going and the plans we're undertaking. Most importantly, he is student-focused and willing to make tough decisions for our students. I'm confident he will continue to build upon relationships he has established with faculty, staff, administration, students, families, to further the mission of the Lancaster Central School. And it's going to be the fourth time I was counting that this is said. As everyone knows, our goal is to hire the best. The hiring process is detail-oriented, rigorous, and focused on finding the right people for Lancaster. I'd like to thank the Board of Education and Dr. Galloway for allowing us to start and then complete the filling of the assistant superintendent process prior to my start in December 1. This gives us an invaluable opportunity to provide transition time and allow us to prepare on all cylinders. And we are hiring the best. I'm excited for Mr. Craven to take over assistant superintendent and know he will continue to do great things for our students and the district. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Any comments or questions from the board?
I'm just making sure. You didn't see it, but it's certainly not like you see it coming to
the all those in favor? Anyone against? Motion carries. Mr. Crazen, would you like to say a few words?
Thank you. This is truly an incredible honor. This place is truly something that's very, very special. When my family and I moved here,
to 11.2, education items. 11.2.1, can I have a motion on the committee on special education? Any comments or questions? All those in favor? Anyone against? Motion carries. 11.2.2, can I have a motion on the committee on preschool special education? Any comments or questions? All those in favor? Anyone against? Motion carries. 11.2.3, can I have a motion to appoint Terry Clifford to the CSC and CPSC? Any comments or questions? All those in favor? Anyone against? Motion carries. 11.2.4 is for information. This is textbook first reading. Ms. AP Spanish Language and Culture. 12.0, business and financial items. 12.1, can I have a motion on the financial items? Any comments or questions? All those in favor? Anybody against? Motion carries. 12.2, can I have a motion on the EIA contract agreement with massive testing and balancing LLC? Any comments or questions? All those in favor? Anyone against? Motion carries. 12.3, can I have a motion on the EIA agreement with McIntosh and McIntosh PNC? Any comments or questions? All those in favor? Anyone against? Motion carries. 12.4, can I have a motion on the surplus books? Any comments or questions? All those in favor? Anyone against? Motion carries. 12.5, can I have a motion on the surplus equipment? Any comments or questions? All those in favor? Anyone against? Motion carries. 12.6, can I have a motion on the contract with Buffalo Public Schools? Any comments or questions? All those in favor? Anyone against? Motion carries. 12.7, can I have a motion on the contract with Jonathan Rizzo? Any comments or questions? All those in favor? Anyone against? Motion carries. 12.8, can I have a motion on the contract with James Welch? Any comments or questions? All those in favor? Anyone against? Motion carries. 12.9, can I have a motion on fund creation and change? Any comments or questions? All those in favor? Anyone against? Motion carries. 12.10, can I have a motion on affiliate food service operating reports? Any comments or questions? All those in favor? Anyone against? Motion carries. 12.11, can I have a motion on the construction change orders? Any comments or questions? All those in favor? Anyone against? Motion carries. 12.12, can I have a motion on the IIF? Any questions? Any comments or questions? All those in favor? Anyone against? Motion carries. 13.0 is a public hearing. We do not have anyone speak this evening. 14.0 is an executive session. Before we go into the executive session, I just want to mention that our next regular session will be December 9th, 2024, in the Lancaster High School Auditorium at 7 p.m. I have a motion to go into executive session. Any comments or questions? The executive session is to discuss student discipline matters with the district attorney. All those in favor? Anyone against? Motion carries. All right. Thank you all for coming out this evening. That effectively ends the public portion of the meeting this evening.